Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mike here at Game From Scratch, and do you want an all-new 3D game engine? Well, I sort of have one for you, and by that I mean we have a new 3D engine from an existing engine of sorts. So what we've got is Cocos Creator. Right now, you may have heard of Cocos Creator. It's used to create 2D games. I'm actually quite a fan of it. I've done a full tutorial series to it. I will link those down below. Not really that popular in the West. This is more of a huge, huge engine over in China, and it's built on top of the Cocos 2DX framework, which in turn was inspired by Cocos 2D, which goes back in time to, I don't know, the Apple II era almost. Nah, it's not quite that far, but probably 15 to 20 years. This guy has been a very long-running framework and a number of different projects built on top of it. But what we are talking about today is kind of confusing in naming. We're looking at Cocos Creator 3D. This is a brand new, from scratch, 3D game engine built underneath Cocos Creator. And when Cocos Creator, that is the 2D game engine, releases version 3, the 2D and 3D branches will be merged together. So what we're looking at is that brand new 3D version of Cocos Creator, available right now in tech preview. And you can see it here in front of you. It is a good looking game engine. And this is a lot like, I don't know, we'll put this somewhere in between Unity and Play Canvas. So if you're looking for a game engine somewhere in between Unity and Play Canvas, well, Cocos Creator could be a really good choice for you. It doesn't have all of the bells and whistles that you would get in a Unity, an Unreal, or a Godot, but a lot of times you don't need those bells and whistles. Plus, it's got the ability to target all kinds of markets you may not have thought about. TikTok, WeChat, and a few others along those lines. But here we are in action. This is a component-based game engine. You can see the editor here. It uses a PBR-based workflow. So what I mean by that is if you go to lighting, lighting is controlled by stats such as color, temperature, and illuminance. Whereas if you go to cameras, where are you in camera? Probably under player. There we go. Go to the camera. You're going to find things such as aperture, shutter, and ISO control how the cameras look. So if you are familiar with traditional filming techniques, you're going to like the workflow here in Cocos Creator. Everything else here is kind of composition based. So you see here, our camera is selected. Our camera is made out of a CC camera, which comes from the underlying open source framework. It is a node type that you can create there, and a node. So it's really similar to other composition-based systems out there. You want to add another component, you can go ahead and add a component right here. You'll see we've got a number of different options here, from particle systems to skin meshes, to lights, to physics. We've got a complete physics engine built in here. There is a train system built in here. And then we've got things like, these are the custom scripts. This is the way you add logic to your world. So let me just go ahead and find, here we go. Here we got game manager, for example. And we got shooting game manager. This is a TypeScript controlled script. You've also, as you can see, got prefab support. And if you've got, so the parameters here, this TypeScript, let me just go ahead and select it. You'll see here, it has a parameter of type prefab. So now you can define a prefab. You can create a prefab and drop that in as a controller on the script. Pretty cool stuff on the whole. Again, it's pretty straightforward TypeScript. You can see here, it uses a traditional game loop callback system. So you've got initialize, on collision, update, when it shuts down, and so on. So you can put your code into those particular areas as you need it. So you program your logic in scripts using either TypeScript, and TypeScript is actually, for Cocos Creator 3D, the only option right now. In the future, JavaScript will also be supported as well. And then when you are ready and good to go, you can basically go ahead and run your current scene, the whole thing, or we can come up here and preview it or run it in our browser. So let's go ahead and run this guy. You're gonna see the project in action. It's gonna fire up and boom. So here is a browser-based game with physics. So we go ahead, we start shooting these out. This is one of the sample projects that are available, by the way. We'll get to those in just a sec. So if you want to come in here and check it out. So there we go. Let's drop some more of those boxes down. Eventually we'll get the Django effect going on here. There we go. Geronimo, down it goes. So you see, you got full physics. You can easily run your games in the browser. Let's just shut that guy down. So out we go. We'll come back to those details in a minute. So here we are back in Cocos Creator. Now, one of those things when you're working with a 3D game engine, one of the first things you're gonna wanna check out is, okay, how do I get content in here? And I gotta say, Cocos Creator gets this right. And this is where a lot of engines get it wrong. So we're gonna create a new scene here in action. So we've got our light and we've got a camera, and that's about it. You can obviously nest things, so I could create something underneath our camera and it'd be parented to it. And now let's look at getting an asset in here. So I've already went ahead and downloaded, let's go here to my downloads folder. I downloaded this scene here from Sketchfab. It's a GLTF file. You can import models in the form of GLTF or FBX. And then I'm just gonna come back here to our assets directory. We're just gonna say, all right, show me that. And then it will open up here. So there is our assets folder. And I'll just paste that guy in. So our new folder is in place. So we can come here, we'll look in the assets folder. There we go. So our new asset is now here and available. The file parser, by the way, is very, very fast. Here you can see all the various different things that went together to create it. So here is our new asset. So I click on it. There you can see a preview of the asset in action. Here, for example, is the texture. You've got control over how the texture is shown. You can see here we've got an 8K texture with some advanced mapping going on. So let's see how well this works. Wow, it works pretty much flawlessly. So that is impressive. I gotta say, even the rendering quality out of the box is pretty solid. I'm impressed in that regard. You wanna go ahead and create your own objects, for example, come in here, and let's just go ahead and create a cube. And then we could go ahead and select our cube, for example, and we could go ahead and create, let's create a sphere under our cube. So now I've got my cube selected, and you got your straightforward controls like so. You can change between rotation, scale, and so on up here. You can also have your pivot based using a gizmo, local controls, and so on. So now I've got my cube, my sphere is directly inside of it. So there we go. So this is parented. So I grab my cube, and obviously the sphere is gonna move along with it. So that's how your scene graph is built up. And then any of these particular things you want, we can go ahead and add logic to it. So I can here add components to it, and I could create, say I wanna make this cube emit audio. I could create an audio source. We could drop an audio clip in here. I don't have one immediately available, but I could just literally, one of these examples has to have an audio clip. Sounds, all right, here we go, coin. There. So you want to drop something in, just boom, drop it in, you're good to go. Or at the same time, you can create your own scripts at any time using JavaScript or TypeScript and control them accordingly. And then those scripts all become available just as standard components once again. So they come in here under the custom scripts. And if they're found over here as a resource, and then let's say we wanted to make this box a bullet, boom, the bullet script is now attached and that thing will control like a bullet. I don't know what that'll actually mean if I test this scene. Now, there's my sound. Okay, I'm well off screen. All right, so let's go on back over it. And then what you can do is you can ultimately, even though you're building web games here, you can install the Android tools or whatever and package this natively for deployment as if it was an executable. So you don't have to just create web applications using this guy. The final thing I'm going to really touch on this guy over here is our assets control. You could bring in and create various different assets over here. So this is where you would create a new TypeScript. You could create a new scene here, a cube map, various different textures, special effects, animations, and so on. There is a full animation timeline base. So if you want to add animation to something, you can add the animation object over here. And then we can create an animation clip to go with it. Well, okay, yeah, sure. We'll name it. And then we can go ahead in animation mode over the timeline, move things around and control keyframed animations over here. This is exact same as it is over in Cocos 2D, but obviously it is in 3D. You can animate all of the various different exposed properties. So for example, I could animate that sound I attached earlier on. So I animate properties such as loop, turn looping on and off. I could switch the volume out so we could have an animation of the character moving across the scene and the soundtrack kind of sinking in and so on. So you got pretty good advanced control over animation in the timeline down here. And then the final thing we could do, for example, is something such as I'll come in here and create. So physics, if you're setting up physics on an object, you control those settings via a physics material like so. And you can control things like friction, rolling, restitution, or bounciness. Or we can create a material like so. I already created one earlier on. Various different effects are available for it. So you see here, we've got a built-in tune shader for this guy right there. And then you can go ahead and set, you know, base color, the line width to use for drawing on your tune shader, and so on. And that is how you go ahead and create materials that you can bring in. Obviously, it uses a PBR-based workflow. You can bring all those things in, etc. And that is a quick look at Cocos Creator. If you really want to check this guy out, I recommend grabbing some of the samples. We'll look at the samples in a second. We got a running sample, an endless runner style game. We got all the junk I made. So we got, okay, abort. So we have a running sample, a shooting sample, as we saw earlier on. And then if we head on over here, we'll take a look. We'll start off here. So first off, we've got the announcement. This is a bit of an overview of what Cocos 3D is all about. I'm not going to run you through too much of it because, quite frankly, well, I just did that. But, you know, they're now here. This is the Cocos Creator 3.0 tech preview. As of right now, this is just 3D. With the release of 3.0, 2D will come back in. So 2D features are not currently available in this version. Things like spline animation, tiled maps, etc. are all not in here yet. They will be when Cocos Creator 3 comes in and 2D and 3D worlds merge together. Those features will come back. And as I said, TypeScript is the primary way to go for right now. We got a bunch of improvements to the editor in general. I didn't really showcase you that, but there's actually a decent amount of options you can do here. The cool thing is it's fully extensible. There are a number of different extensions that you can do. So most of the editor itself is created in a modular way. So you can go ahead and download extensions that other people have created, or if you really want to, you can come in here and create your own extensions. So you can really add on to what the engine itself is capable of. And then if we come over here, go into the preferences, you're gonna see some of the options that are available to you. So some of these things are experimental. The train feature is currently an experiment, for example. You can set up where things are, all the various different tools you depend on, Android, NDK, SDKs, WeChat tools, and so on. You got remote debugging options available. There's a device simulator out there for various different devices you can test with, or you can create your own, give it the ratio and resolution, et cetera. So if you wanna do your testing, when you test your stuff, you've got a number of different popular devices out there that the form factors are already simulated. You've got ability to drop in custom engines in here. There's a solid amount of functionality in here. And again, everything is super extensible. So you can create your own extensions, or you can use community driven extensions, which I'm assuming, you know, as it's going to get more mature, you'll get more and more extensions available. Improvements to the UI across the board. TypeScript, it has been rewritten with TypeScript, mainly for some key features. TypeScript provide for auto completion in Visual Studio Code. We also suggest developers only use in their projects, so you can enjoy code completion, module auto import, API documentation, etc. using Visual Studio Code. As you saw, you're getting auto completion right there, and the documentation links over automatically. Plus, I gotta agree with them. I would use TypeScript 100 times out of 100 over JavaScript personally, so they don't really need to sell me on that one. We got improvements to 3D modeling and animation support. Cocos Creator itself had support for very basic 3D, so you could do things like put 3D models into a 2D world, but 3 goes way beyond that. We got things, morph target support for doing things like, you know, facial animation you see here. GPU simulation instanced animations going on. You can do attachments to joints of skeletons for things like weapon systems. And then we got, again, the PBR-based rendering. That is using real-world things such as exposure, ISO, shutter settings, color temperature for lighting, and so on. Material system is the same as 2.4, so it really hasn't really changed that much. 3D visual effects systems, improvements, physics, 3D physics are in there. You got fog, and so on. So there's quite a bit going on here. There are a number of demos to get you up and going. We've got the example 3D. This is a number of different showcases available here. So skinning, we got the classic Sponza level there for the, you know, seeing a 3D level in action. We have the classic helmet as well. So if you want to just kind of get in there and see how various different things work, so example, collision detection or creating your own custom shaders or tune shading, etc., there are examples for that. There's also the samples that I showed you. There's a simple running, endless runner style game, and a shooting game, which we saw in action just a few seconds ago. There's also the test cases library. I don't really know why you would come here, but it is available. And then finally, we've got a full complete game available called the taxi game. I will admit, this one is very Chinese in that the tool, the editor, and most of the code is Chinese only. And there's a 17-part video tutorial series showing you how to go ahead and create this thing. But again, very Chinese oriented in, you know, the comments and the structure and so on. So probably of somewhat limited value until it gets ported to English. But that is actually being done. So that's pretty cool there. And the place where you probably want to start, though, is this repository right here. Just clone it down, open it up, and you are good to go. And you see you got a ton of different examples available to get you started, and then two full, complete, simple games, and then a game lobby. And yeah, that's it. That is Cocos Creator 3.0. Well, I guess this is Cocos Creator 3D Preview for the upcoming Cocos 3.0, where the 2D and the 3D game engine will be merged together. Head on back over to the engine for a second. I got to admit, again, out of the box, the lighting and rendering engine works quite well. I had previously said straight out, if I was going to do a HTML5 targeted game, I would probably choose Play Canvas. Now, if I needed a full editor, I don't know. I think Cocos Creator 3D might actually get the nod. Now, it's going to be interesting to see how mature this one becomes, how fast it gets localized, how many bugs they have. One of the things that bothered me in the past with Cocos Creator is they have this bad habit of breaking things from release to release for reasons that I find somewhat questionable at time. Hopefully the API behind Cocos Creator 3 stays very stable so that, you know, if I write a tutorial about it, it isn't broken in, you know, the next release. But we'll be interested to see how that ultimately turns out. But let me know what you thought of Cocos Creator 3D. Also, let me know if you'd be interested in tutorials showing you how to use this, or at least the early version that's available to us. Let me know. I will talk to you all later, and goodbye.